I'm in Server Manager on a domain controller, and if I go to Tools, I can see the option for Group Policy Management. And when the management comes up, we can see all the different organizational units that are in Active Directory users and computers. They're also showing up here as well. And here is the root of our domain. So if we change anything to the default domain policy, it's going to affect everyone in the organization unless they have a block inheritance turned on. So for instance, if I go to accounting finance and right click and I choose block inheritance, you can see a new icon appears. And what's going to happen is if I set up the default domain policy to, say, change a user's password requirements, it's going to affect everyone except users in the accounting finance OU. I can remove it by simply right-clicking and unchecking the box. Here we see other group policy objects, such as Teams install. So what this is going to do is it's going to automatically install Teams into everyone's computers. Now, this is at the root level, so that means it's going to affect everyone unless they have that block inheritance. And the reason I created this one rather than editing the default domain policy was because it's easier to understand what each function is rather than hunt for it. For example, if I right-click and choose Edit on the default domain policy, you're going to see hundreds of different options, and it's very difficult to find which one it is that you went and edited. So for instance, I'll go to the administrative templates, go to control panel, and look at all these different options I have. And when you click on a specific option, such as do not display the lock screen, you can choose enabled or disabled, and what the effect is if you don't choose either. Click cancel. There are other options that include many more things other than just being enabled or disabled. For instance, if I choose the restricts the UI language and choose enabled, then we get this drop down. And look at all these different options that we can choose. And there's many other different options that choose even more drop downs in that particular option. Here we see that these particular options are going to be under the computer configuration. And we have policies. We also have preferences. And inside preferences, we see Windows settings as well as control panel settings. And beneath that, we see data sources, folder options, etc. I'm going to minimize all the computer settings, and we're going to take a look at the user settings. So under user configurations, we once again have policies, we have preferences, and inside each of those, we have various different folders. Now, some of these policies and preferences are going to be exactly the same as the computer configuration, while others will only make sense to users or computers rather than both. Let's take a look at the administrative templates. And I'll click on desktop, for instance, and we have lots of different options. For instance, we can hide certain things. We can hide the network locations. We can remove the My Documents icon on the desktop, which is now called Documents. We can remove the recycle bin from the desktop as well. The recycle bin will still be there, it just won't be shown on the desktop, and you'll have to find it another way. I'm going to close this group policy object called default domain policy. And every other policy looks like this as it starts out. So if I right click on the everyone gets this, then you're going to see it all looks exactly the same. It's just different options were enabled. If we look on the right hand side, you can see things like the scope, the details, settings, and delegation. So for instance, I can go down to where it says security filtering. Right now, by default, it's all authenticated users. But I can remove that and I can add in other things, such as I can type in HR, click check names, and say the HR group. So now this is only going to apply to the HR group users that are in the domain. And if I apply this to a specific OU, such as HR, then it's only going to apply to HR users in the domain, in the HR organizational unit. So you can definitely filter these things down even further. I can also go into details, and I can choose to enable or disable this particular option. And I can go to settings, and it shows me a report of all the different things that have been checked. So if you can't find which ones have been enabled, then you can go to this section choose the show all, and you can see things like this particular link has been enforced. Or you can scroll down and choose any other option that may have been enforced as well. Then we have the delegation option, and this will show you who has the ability to make changes to this group policy object. And by default, you're going to see the admins typically have that. We also see the HR group as well. Group policy objects are just a collection of permissions and capabilities applied to users, groups, and computers.